stuff that happens in Logan is just ongoing. These fellas over here like to cover it up every time. Every time something happens in Logan, the PLOs get together and have a meeting with their police officers, and then the situation's all right. The situation ain't all right. Who gave them the right to speak on behalf of our people? I know I did it. The only right they got to speak on behalf of our people is nothing, as far as I'm concerned. They don't represent any of our people. They do nothing for our people. I've been speaking with these people in Logan for the last, I don't know how many years now. And I get nothing from them. So we've got to hold Logan police accountable. They've got to come to the table. Enough is enough.
That's the two things then.
We can only stop this from where we are now, and that's by coming together as people as we are. That's what they hate, as you can see, is when we come together. Every time something happens, we've got to come together, and we're going to do this every single time until they stop. And this is going to stop today and in the future, because we're going to march every single day if we have to. But we will get the message out there to these fellas. We've got no confidence in these fellas. We've got no confidence whatsoever. They're supposed to be public servants. For who? For nobody. But thank you very much for listening, and I hope we all have a really good march today and support each other through this, as we are going in the future. Thank you very much.
Hi, my name's Tony Robertson. I used to say to people I was born in Geelong. I don't say that anymore. I was born in Wathaurong country, and I acknowledge the traditional owners of the land I was born in and the land that I now live in. I've come to rallies and gatherings over recent years with my camera, and I've documented and recorded the stories, the t-shirts and the messages, because when I look at my social media pages, I don't see much about black deaths in custody from my white fellow friends. And that disturbs me. I look around now and I don't see many of my white fellow friends in the recognised campaign standing here in solidarity. That worries me. I look around now, I don't see many of my white fella religious people who are keen on Aboriginal issues. I don't see them here. That worries me. They write documents, they look in books, but they don't come on the street, and they don't stand here with you. So I stand here with you for them, but the challenge for me is to disturb them so they too will come on the street. That's why I bring my camera to these events, to take photographs, to put them out there, so that these stories, these memories of Daniel, of Maruchi, of Sean, will be treasured, told, and so my white fellow people will be motivated to express solidarity with more power, more anger, and more strength. Thank you.
More speakers? Well, we'll start by winding up.
Oh, got it. Which, yep, do that. Yeah.
Okay.
Yes.
But, first people by acknowledging the traditional owners of this country here, our existence and our spirit existence in this country here. Also to acknowledge our sovereignty never ceded. We're still here. Same fight all the time, come back to the same thing. Come back to our sovereign rights of this country. Our ownership, our responsibility to our country and to our people, all in one. These things wouldn't happen if they give the responsibility back to our people. the responsibility is back to our young people. Look after one another. And all in all. But I can invite anyone up here, any young people, anyone to come up now to sing Haring and Army to start the march off here.
Come on, Helen.
Come and join us.
Helen. Come on.
So we can sing up the power and the spirit of our country.
Come on, where are
the
you?
The meaning of the song, here we are, here.
All you young people, come on.
Call up all that good energy, all that strong power from our country and bring it up to our heart. Speak to our minds to carry us through this march here today. Go!
To get these petitions signed and get the matter raised into the parliament, and then from there we'll be coming into November, and in November there will be one big death and custody march in the middle of November, because we have the anniversary of Daniel Yock's death and custody on November 7th, and we've got the anniversary of Mawindji Dumaji on the 19th of November. So it'll be a big month, and as young Janine pointed out before, we had that terrible case in West Australia of Mr. Lee Kadoo, who was put into jail for non-payment of traffic fines that amounted to $1,000. And she died in custody. And that's what an Aboriginal life is worth, and I'm not even $1,000. That struggle is still going on. So every one of our communities right across the countryside has enormous problems trying to achieve justice around improper arrest, improper treatment of our people, and certainly around the death and custody rate. So we're going to pull up behind the flag and then march down police headquarters. Thank you.
Yeah. EMPA gear, right? So what we're going to do is run about 300 metres short of police headquarters. Push everyone apart. Just move people over. Form a bit of a cordon with our PLOs and whatever. Get men up in front of the approach everything to the scene. So once you're all set up, ready to go, let us know. We'll let the boss know that we're going.